Kadeem Allen, up from the G League, Wally, making the most of the opportunity tonight. 14 points. By far a career high for him.
And I just loved his poise out there, especially in crunch time, because on a night where Dennis Smith Jr. alluded to was just struggling a little bit after his big-time performance last night, the Knicks needed someone to go out there and organize the team and get them in offense and get them good possessions. And that shows a lot, you know, for a young player like Kadeem Allen to take that ownership of the team and take that responsibility with just coming out of the G League a couple weeks ago. So that's a really good sign for the Knicks, and, you know, they're going to need performances like that in order to close out these games down the stretch.
You can see David Fizdale starting to trust him, right?
Yeah.
Another guard who can get into the paint and create and get make things happen, pass as well with the six assists, and he had him in there in crunch time. You know, and so that shows you the trust factor that he has in him.
Interesting. He had Kadeem Allen and Dennis Smith Jr. out there at the same time.
You needed two ball handlers out there, especially against the way the Raptors play, how they definitely share the ball. Here's a guy. The Celtics loved him. They had him in their G League team. They had him, actually brought him up a couple of times as well last year. The fans really liked him. They just didn't have a spot for him on their team. So he took an opportunity with the Knicks and their G League team and made the most of it. Now has found himself back.
He's very good
in the NBA.
The basket.
That's what it is. He attacks and he forces movement with defense. He showed you tonight he can knock down the outside shot, 2 or 3 from downtown. But that's really his game is dribble penetration, active body. And we know the story about him showing up. Was a little out of shape for training camp, which is amazing to think, but lost 20 pounds to get himself back into game shape. And that's what you like to see, a guy that wants to make sure that, you know what, if I'm going to make it, I want to make sure that I have no excuses, that when it ends, I know it wasn't because of something I can control, right? And that's something I think he had to figure out. Get yourself in shape and make sure that you have a chance in your career.
Rebecca, as we just heard her talk to Kyle Lowry, mentioned Mitchell Robinson.
Mm-hmm.
And Mitchell Robinson, 15 points career high, 7 rebounds and 3 more blocks, only played 22 minutes. His efficiency, and you love that number,
is through the
roof right now.
Player efficiency is absolutely through the roof. And you just see him getting smarter out there before our eyes. You see him not committing the foolish fouls like he was early on in the season. And you're seeing him be the bailout guy for the guards when they go to the basket, cleaning up the messes all over the place. He's a tremendous offensive rebounder, has an incredible motor to just attack that ball and just look at these blocks. I mean, the closing he does of space with his length and with his athleticism and with his arms, he just goes after every ball with an absolute vengeance. That's something that can't be taught in a big man. That's a huge skill to have as a big man, to just play with a relentless motor, and he has it. And it's really exciting to see him healthy and playing this way, because he is electrifying some of the plays that he can make on the NBA, in the world's most famous arena.
Player efficiency rating is 19.7 going into this game.
And what's the number?
Over 15 is phenomenal.
Yeah.
15's of
NBA stars
15,
are like in the 20s.
Yeah,
the stars
like
are
the
in the 20s.
Yeah, the real all-stars.
Yeah, like Harden's 30. You know, like you have a guy like that who's 30.
But anything over 20 is like all-star material. And, but when he's on the floor, getting up around 20, that's pretty good
stuff. Just think about it. He's barely playing 20 minutes, not even playing 20 minutes a game. 2 blocks a game as a rookie, and his block percentage is almost 10%, which is incredible. 10% of the shots that he's near, he blocks them,
that's
which is off the charts.
His blocks per 36 minutes blow anyone away in the league.